Hello, my name is Daniel Patek and I shortly want to demonstrate my 3D dungeon generator. In the dungeon generator object, it has a dungeon generator script which is responsible for a big part of the configuration. So here you can add all the room prefabs and depending on the type. And if you add, for example, a hallway and multiple times, it gets chosen more oftenly, and therefore you increase the probability that that gets chosen. And therefore, it can have you can have smaller dungeons if you add more hallway ends or dead ends, because then the probability is higher that it will not take a cross or one of these rooms, and or even the big room with a lot of entrances where a lot more possibilities can appear. You can also choose the type of the first room that gets chosen from which the dungeon starts to generate, and the position of the first room. Here the a safe end is added, which is this door, so if the way is blocked, then this gets chosen. But I will show you that later. So let's take a look at one of the rooms. In the room, you have that script. You need to add all the entrance objects here so that it knows where at which entrances it needs to spawn new rooms. A trigger box is added, which is this one, which is not completely the size, but nearly the size of the room, that is used for checking collision if if that room can be spawned or not. And back to the room. You can here also choose the room type. That entrance type currently is not used, but could be in the future. And then we have the room entrance. Which can be connected or not. The connection that is mainly only visible to see, okay, if it got connected or not. Then it has, let's take a look at one of these objects. It has a small box collider, which is an actual collider and a trigger, and it also needs a rigid body because of the function that uses it to trigger that, because when another room gets spawned adjacent to this room, that box need to be trigger that thing, but yeah, that box from the other room, so from the other entrance. So therefore that rigid body is needed, because only then the function checks it. And these objects can have a probability for the allowed rooms. So these scriptable objects have the different probabilities defined in which probability each type of room has on top of the and the probability that I showed that you can not do with a slider yet, but by just adding more of the same type of room in the dungeon generator. This If then this gets chosen, then that type of room gets chosen more oftenly, probably. And you can also say, okay, we only want one type with 100% probability. So then only hallway rooms get chosen at such point. So that has each room that at each room entrance, room opening. And so let's see a demonstration of what happens if we press generate. It starts to, okay, this time it's a really small dungeon, but yeah, each time it spawns a room or tries to spawn a room, it creates one of these boxes, which is get from the chosen room, the blue collider, and checks if it can be spawned there, and if not, then it chooses a different room and tries again, and up to 50 times. And then it gives up and spawns a safe end. So let's try that again. Again, a really small dungeon, but you can see, okay, it tested if it can spawn a big room here. Let's try it again. Okay, now we get a little bit bigger, bigger dungeon. If no blue boxes appear anymore, then we know it's done. Or if we don't see any entrances like these or like we have seen here, then we also know, okay, that still needs to spawn something as well. And it can take quite a while because it, does not test after a certain system, but more like random, and after the probabilities if it can spawn something there or not. So it can really take a while. But it seems okay, no blue boxes more. So this dungeon is done, and we can take a small look. So yeah, we can walk here, see there's one of these safe ends because it can't go through the wall. And here it's blocked, and here we get also blocked one. So this is a dead end, but we have seen that from outside already. And we can also go down here and check where it leads us. Yes. So all the rooms are always be connected. Some lead into Dead's End at a certain point. So, but in general, you can reach every room. Okay, thank you for watching this demo. I hope it helped.